With better access to public LiDAR data than ever before, and vertical accuracies in the range of 1 foot or better becoming the norm, it's difficult to imagine having any trouble creating perfectly smooth contour lines. But working with massive LiDAR point cloud data, it's actually common to run into the opposite problem: too much information. Let me show you what I mean. Here's a site near Boyce, Louisiana, that I'm looking at in the Equator platform. Public USGS LiDAR data exists here, and when I look at the metadata associated with the LiDAR, it shows that this is QL1 data, quality level 1. According to the USGS LiDAR base specification, QL1 data means that you can expect the non-vegetated vertical accuracy to be 19.6 centimeters at a 95% confidence level. In short, this means this is high quality data. And you can clearly see that from the trees, power lines, and houses that are represented by the points. So there's no reason why we should not be able to generate beautiful contours from this information. If we export the LiDAR point cloud and bring it into Civil 3D and generate a surface directly from the point cloud, here is what we get. Instead of contours that used to look rough because of a lack of information, now our contours have so much detail they're hard to read. In some areas, this level of detail is super useful. Look at the opening of this crossing. You can clearly see the steep slope and definition of the opening. This is a detail we don't want to lose as the project progresses. But if we check out the contours along the embankment and along the roadway, this level of detail may be a bit overkill for visualization and may make the resulting base plans even difficult to read. Now let's explore the use of a digital elevation model, or DEM, to create a surface in Civil 3D. We can use Equator to convert the USGS LiDAR into a DEM. So in this example, let's try creating a 1 meter DEM from the LiDAR data. Here I'm creating a new tin surface in Civil 3D from the 1 meter DEM exported from Equator. Let's compare the result to the original LiDAR point cloud surface. As you can see, along the roadway and slopes, the DEM results in a nice, smooth surface and smooth contours. But in contrast, at the culvert crossing, we have jagged contours that are snapping to the 1 meter grid of the DEM. The 1 meter DEM does not contain enough detail to represent the steep slope here. Let's take a quick profile through these two surfaces along the center of the road. Along this path, there are no abrupt changes in elevation or steep slopes. So the profile is nearly identical when you compare the two surfaces. So in this area, using the 1 meter DEM to generate the surface is a great option. Now let's take another quick profile, this time through the culvert crossing. Again, in the middle of the road, where it's relatively flat, the profiles match almost perfectly between the two surfaces. But check out the culvert opening. Here you can see the difference. Once again, it's clear that the 1 meter DEM does not contain enough detail to represent this feature. So how can we combine these two data formats to capture a variable level of detail and generate smooth contours? To start, I'm going to create a tin surface from a 1 meter DEM. I'll give this surface a name and turn on 0.5 meter contours for visualization purposes. Next, I will look for areas in my surface where the 1 meter DEM does not provide sufficient detail. Again, this would be steep slopes and areas with abrupt elevation changes. To keep it simple, I'm just going to say the culvert inlet and outlet are the only areas I need more detail for this site. Now I will open Equator and extract the LiDAR point cloud for these two spots. I have exported only the ground LiDAR points in LAS format. And I've already converted the LAS files into an RCS file, a format that Civil 3D can read. I'm going to click on Attach Point Cloud and select the file that I have created in the RCS format. Make sure that Specify on Screen is unchecked so that the point cloud lands in the right spot in relation to the rest of your work. Here you can see I'm just adjusting the level of the detail on the point cloud so that you can visualize more or less of those points, and then clicking on Create Surface from Point Cloud. I'll just give it a name, select the point cloud, make sure that no filter is checked, and then click on Create Surface. Now go back to your first surface, right click on Edits, and select Paste Surface. A menu will open with all of the surfaces in your drawing file. Select the surface built from the point cloud and hit OK. You can repeat this procedure with all of the areas where you want to add more detail. And as you can see, the result is a hybrid surface where the point cloud is used in some areas and the DEM in other areas. This approach results in a surface with a variable level of detail based on the project needs and nice smooth contours for visualization purposes. We tested out this procedure in a few areas across Canada and the US, and it worked like a charm. So feel free to follow along in your own site and let me know how it goes.